my heart.
Hey y'all. Sup. We out here. Guess where we at? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Guess.
What are you doing?
So we in Africa, you feel me?
I feel like we in goddamn Africa.
Feel me? Hey, where we at?
North Carolina.
Yeah, we got to North Carolina.
We in North Carolina.
We came down here for a shower. My sister's baby shower, my baby sister's baby shower. So we in a hotel right now. We got here Friday, right?
Yep.
Friday around 7 o'clock. Yeah, and we've just been here.
Like
we leave tomorrow.
So damn big.
We leave tomorrow morning. It's cute, babe.
Yeah, we leave. I don't got no makeup on. Don't do
you look beautiful with no makeup like that. Look at this. Put your face in my hand when I do that. That dumbass is gonna do that shit. So this was Heaven's first time meeting my family, and babe, how did it go? I feel like it went good, but language was a big problem. Cause I couldn't control speaking tree.
You could control speaking tree.
But it's like when I speak, it's like, oh damn, I gotta convert.
No, you didn't even do it. Let me say. We are in North Carolina. We came out here yesterday, right?
Yeah. No, we came here Friday.
So yesterday was her sister's baby shower, and it was my first time meeting her sisters and really any part of her family. I have been on the phone speaking to them for years, but I've never really seen them. They've always been out of the country, so now they reside, both of her sisters, she has two sisters and a brother. Both of her sisters now reside in the States, so this was like the first opportunity for everyone to be in the same place at once. We road tripped here from New York with her cousin, so I met her cousin, and then I met her sisters and her aunts when we got to the shower. Now here's the thing, I know their primary language is tree, but I'm also aware that they all speak English, and I never once thought, okay, this is going to be such an issue because they all speak English. They know I don't speak tree. So, and then I thought this is a baby shower. You know, I know the her sister's husband was going to be there. His friends were going to be there. Now, one, I didn't think her sister's husband was Ghanaian.
Dude, that was double threat.
I don't know why I thought he was white.
Oh.
Or American. I didn't think he was Ghanaian. So when I found out he was Ghanaian, I was like, okay, that's cool. But I thought that it would be Americans there. So I didn't think they would speak tree all the time. I'm saying tree. So what was the culture shock for me was that no one spoke a bit of English during the whole shower.
Like they'll chime in a little bit.
They would say probably one word here and there, but for the most part, it was all of their language. So I was sitting there not really understanding much of what was happening, what was going on, the jokes, the topic, the subject, you know, it just wasn't happening, which was unfortunate because I felt like that was,
man.
I was so excited and was looking forward to bonding with her family, but so I was like, okay. When they would speak to me in particular, they were speaking English, but they were speaking around me in their language, and I was just there. So after the shower, still I was able to speak to people and have conversations, and you know, it wasn't like I was totally not there. What else? So then the shower ended. We were there until like the end of the shower. So that was amazing. I still got to meet everybody, take pictures and dance and eat the food and all that other stuff. So that was an amazing thing. Then we got back to the hotel and I let her know these things. And she was like, oh man, I didn't even realize. So I'm like, okay. And I was like, but it's fine. You know, you've seen your family, you haven't seen them in a long time. It's cool. So this morning, we knew we were going to go back to her sister's house. Her sister live out here. And go chill with them some more. Again, she haven't seen them in a long time. They only met me once. It was just a shower. So we're going to go chill over there. We go back, we go in the house. For the next hours we're in there, it happens again. No one speak a lick of English. Not one bit of English. So I don't feel a way because again, this is their language. I'm gonna tell them not to speak their language. But here's how I feel though. I feel like they are used to speaking their, especially around their family. They're not at work. They're not around coworkers that, you know. But this one, to me, in my opinion, I felt like it was her responsibility to bridge the gap. You know, I felt like it was her responsibility to say, hey, my wife doesn't really speak this language. Can we try to incorporate English words or translate for me so I can laugh at jokes? Because it's not like they were talking about me, or I don't know. But it didn't seem like they were talking about me. It just seemed like they were just talking in general and joking and laughing and giggling. But I couldn't join because I didn't understand. So after I just told her how I felt at the hotel room, we get back to her sister's house today. And this is what frustrates me, is that she was doing it more than them. She was doing
I was.
You were speaking the tree just as much as they were.
Well, I didn't start any conversation.
You started. I thought that you would try to just be more inclusive for me, or just have me in mind, like, okay, she doesn't really understand what we're saying. You know, I don't really know. I don't know. This is our first time in this situation.
Yeah.
So, to me, it was a culture shock.
Yeah, next time it'll be better. Next time it'll be better.
She lying. I feel like the only way I can be around her family and really feel included is if I speak the language. So I wish after these 5 years of us being together, she would have let me know a little bit. Like, I feel like you should have told me that that's all y'all speak.
No, we speak English too.
Yeah, but y'all didn't. Not one time. Not
it's
one time.
It's not my fault they didn't speak English,
but
though.
You didn't even make it. You were bringing me to meet your family knowing, first of all, you got a solo. And you was so dead set on me meeting your family.
Right.
That you never once thought, they probably not going to speak English around.
That wasn't in my mind.
Not one time.
Yeah, it didn't cross my mind.
Because you thought they would speak English, or you thought that, or you just didn't
think about
it?
I thought they would speak English, and I didn't think about it too. I didn't think too much into it. So now the next time I'm gonna be like extra cautious, like.
Yeah, but I told you about it as a baby shower, and today you did the same thing. I don't even think you can. I really think the only way I could be around your family is to learn a language. Cause I really can't depend on you to be like, hey, family, my sister doesn't speak it. Can we just be? I don't know. Other than that, though, I had an amazing time. I wish you would stop putting the camera this way, honey. Like,
am I supposed to put it this way?
You don't have to put your hand up. Just put it down. Just not have me here. Not have me
here.
Okay,
I'm not having you here.
You are having me
here. Right here.
You can put your elbow down because you'll complain in 2 seconds.
You like the food, though?
Love the food. Love the music. Love the culture. I love it.
I didn't think language was gonna be a problem.
I don't understand why you keep saying that.
I didn't think of it. I'm not saying it's not a problem. Now it's a problem.
But I didn't think about it. But how?
I didn't think about it. I can't control what I'm thinking. I didn't think about it. I was thinking about the vibes. I think if y'all gonna get along, like somebody gonna say something funny because we're gay. I didn't think about
the fact that no one speaks the language. I don't speak the language at all.
I didn't think about you.
You didn't think about I think that's what you need to say. I think you need to say that you didn't think about the fact that I am not going to know the language y'all are going to speak. I don't even know if I should be upset, because I'm not really upset. I just feel like a little bit.
You could be upset because you wanted to. It's like when you really want to be included in something
I was really looking forward to meeting your family, and then I meet them, and then I don't understand nothing anyone's saying. And not like they don't speak English, because they do. It's just that they chose not to, and I feel like that wasn't even their fault. It was more like your fault, because you didn't say, hey, my wife doesn't understand it. You understand? Like, yeah. I don't know. I feel like if it was me and I was Spanish and I only spoke Spanish and you didn't, I'd be like, yo, yeah, we got to change up. You know, we got to speak English because my wife don't get it. You know, and I'm not going to sit here and speak for hours.
I was two instances where they were speaking Chi and I spoke English and then they went back to Chi. I'm like, all right, I give up.
But you didn't, but that's because they didn't know. They don't know. They don't know.
Yeah.
You know, how can they, they can't read our mind. They can't read your mind. Yeah. But I feel like with you being their family, you could have said, hey, y'all, can we just make sure, like, you didn't even say that.
Right.
It was as if you didn't want to say it.
It's crazy. I gotta look deep into this shit. I'm gonna teach you Chi though. I'm gonna teach you Chi. And if you don't understand it, we're gonna switch to English.
No, y'all not.
Yeah.
It's so embedded in y'all, you know?
Yeah. Because when we used to go to school, international schools, and we came back home, we never spoke English. We spoke Chi. It's not even on purpose.
Because I don't really think anybody. I don't think anyone was being offensive.
Yeah.
It wasn't like no one was being funny. I just really think that is
uncomfortable.
No, I just think that y'all was doing it as naturally. I mean, I just think it's an. I don't speak another language, so I don't know. But yeah. If I was around my family,
your ex was Spanish. So how did they go? They spoke English.
They spoke English in front of me. Yeah, because even when I used to work at jobs and I would have a conversation with my coworker and then my other coworker would come up and they would talk Spanish, but it's all three of us in the conversation. I go, excuse me.
Right.
You know? But I remember watching this episode of The Real, and it was a clip of Tamar. She was saying how that is rude. And Adrian Bellon was like, how is that rude? And we're talking our language.
Right.
You know, and she was like, well, it's rude if I don't speak it. You know, if I don't speak it.
That was a huge debate.
It is. I think it is an interesting debate. I think that's why I wanted to make a YouTube video about it. Not because I didn't want to come off as.
Yeah, I want to know if there are, like, cultural couples here on there who could give us, you know, their experience. Like
their cultural difference. Yeah. Because I feel as though if I would have thought it would have been this much of a deal, I probably would have waited on things.
Mm-hmm. It would have been worse.
No, I would have waited. I wouldn't want. I don't know. I didn't think it was going to be
a big problem.
I feel like I'm more disappointed. That you didn't think to consider. What would have been the difference?
What was the language?
We've established that, babe.
Yeah, I'm saying so next time it's not going to be the language.
I don't know why you keep saying next time it's not going to be that way. You can't make them. Either way, I had an amazing time. I'm glad we came out here. I'm glad I met them. But I did want to make this a YouTube video because I wanted to.
I've never seen a face smell this fast.
Yeah. I look a crazy, crazy hot mess, but I'm so comfortable and so relaxed. I'll tell you that. So comfortable, so relaxed. So peaceful out here, so quiet. But yeah, I wanted to make this video for our YouTube because I wanted to know if any other couples were going through it or probably would understand what probably how Rita feels or how I feel. Because I'm not upset. This is their language, you know. I can't blame them for speaking a language. And I, like I said before, I don't think anyone was trying to be rude. Because they was doing it impulsively. Where you going?
I'm gonna get my slippers.
You gonna get your slippers right now?
No, I'm gonna get ice. They're right here.
Okay. Okay, I don't think that anyone was being rude or being disrespectful because everyone was really cool. It was a nice vibe and they were welcoming and we had conversations and talked. I do wish, though, that Rita probably would have considered the fact that I was sitting there and not understanding. And I think that I think Rita probably could have had the control or the power to just be like, you know, hey y'all, let's just keep in mind that my wife is here and she doesn't really speak a lot of tree, so we can just like kind of speak English or whatever. But when I tell y'all, every question she asked or everything she said, every joke she made, it was in tree. And I was like, you're not making it any better. Even if she was understanding and listening to everybody and responding in English, I would have understood more of what was being said or what was being talked about or joked about or whatever. But because she was talking just as much tree as them, I was like, okay, Rita, I don't know what you're trying to do here. So yeah, we would love to know what you guys think about it, the topic, and the situation. Right?
Yeah.
You want to come over here? No. Okay. Well, you're going to have to take the camera again.
I'm going to what?
Have to take the camera again.
Wait.
I don't want no ice.
Need it.
I don't want no ice.
Come on. It's been a minute.
I don't want it. I don't like it on my teeth.
Alright, y'all. 15 minute video. Give us your comments. Subscribe, like. Come into another state near you soon. Fim? Hi, babe.
Yeah, so what's the question that we want them to answer? And I do want to reiterate that.
What question?
The question that we want them to answer.
I forgot.
The topic. What's the topic?
Language.
What? All right. Okay. Let's say bye, baby.
No, what question? Like, I really forgot.
I don't know. I was trying to come up with something we would want them to answer, but I guess it's just the whole topic in general.
Oh, so who was wrong? Not who was wrong. It's,
what would you have done if you was in Rita's position?
Yeah, what would you have done if you were in my position? Would you have just spoke your language because it is what it is, or you would have tried to chime? Like, what would you have done?
Oh, what would you have done if you was in my position?
Yeah.
Cause yeah. I could have been like, "Hello, what you said, huh? what was that? I missed right. that. What was that?" Cause maybe some people would comment below and be like, "Well, Heaven could have said something too."
You're right.
But these are Guyanians. I'm not gonna be in there like
gang gang.
Yeah. And then they're really be talking shit about me. I try to be as respectful as possible.
That's good. All right. Thank you for watching. I was holding it the whole time. I don't know why that.
You survive.
But I'm saying I was holding it perfectly. Now it's like I don't like the way I'm holding.
Because you're eating that ice and you're so focused. Anywho. All right, let us know how y'all feel. We're going to continue to enjoy this trip before we go back to New York and get back to work. And a lot of other things that we got going on. If y'all can y'all watch the last two uploads we put up? Thank y'all so much. And let us know, what would y'all do if y'all was in my situation or her situation? And who's wrong? Am I wrong for feeling away? Is she wrong for not feeling away? Maybe I shouldn't feel no way. Which I really don't. I don't really feel away.
I haven't seen them for 10 years, so it was like everything was just... I haven't seen my family in 10 years, so everything was just flowing, you know?
Right. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you got lost in the sauce.